Good evening, everyone. You are looking live on Coach Belcher Stadium, home of the Uintah Utes. We're live at Uintah High School, where the Utes are going to host the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons in a great region action game. I'm Mark Mason, and with me tonight is Kevin Dixon. And Kevin, welcome to the broadcast. We've missed you this season so far.
Oh, thanks. It's good to be back. Been able to go to a couple games, but just not announce.
Yeah. So the Utes looking good. I think Coach Heaps has the program building in the right direction. Right now, sitting at 3-4, had a couple of tough outings.
Yeah, tough region. And you're right. I think the football program is on the right track. Kids are doing a lot of great things. And most of them, when you look, they're enjoying the ball game. And to me, that's the most important thing.
Yeah. And right now, one of the things I like the most about the Utes is, in years past, it's been the one or two players, and it's, calling their number over and over again. Right now, the Utes have five or six options on the field that are a threat on any given play. We've seen, the receivers, Corbin Allen, the Brakefield brothers. We see Cruz, Leyba out of the backfield along with Jones and Walters, number 24, and a lot of different styles of play. Henderson's doing some good work out of the quarterback position. So, interesting to see how they play. Spanish Fork, you look at their record and you would say they're on a down year. But this is a team that's, lost by a couple. Gone into an overtime against Springville. And these are teams that, ranked highly in the state and in region.
Right. I mean, the only blowout game they have is the one that they won. The first game of the season. Everything else, they've played good ball teams and have been right in the game.
Yeah, so something to watch out for is the Spanish Fork Dons. Always a tough out, and we were able to talk to Coach Preston Parrish, and it's interesting with Spanish Fork, they've had three head coaches in 3 years.
Yeah, that is interesting, especially in a program like Spanish Fork.
Yeah, and you used to have Spanish Fork, and years past, down in the region, it was Spanish Fork and then everyone north of them.
Right.
Know? The Timpviews and the Orems and that, but Spanish Fork was the team. And now, with the rapid population growth down there, everyone's kind of siphoning off some of their talent from the coaching staff to the players. But still, Spanish Fork Mighty Dons a tough out.
Right. And a lot of programs, you get that the new schools and it devastates one of the old. Certainly didn't do that with Spanish Fork.
No. Yes. Can maintain it, and to have three head coaches. I don't care how similar their styles or their offenses are. It's change and these kids to adapt. And so you look at the roster, a lot of sophomores and freshmen. I mean, they're freshmen and sophomore and junior, excuse me. And talking to one of the coaches for Spanish Fork, they said, this year it was just open competition from day one and really trying to bring some of those younger guys along.
And sometimes when you coach, those are absolutely the most fun years, when nobody feels that they haven't made, that everybody has to work for a starting position, and they're probably the most rewarding as a coach.
Yeah, for sure. So Coach Preston Parrish, in his first year, talked to him before the game, and he says we have to play with as much physicality and effort as Uintah. So he knows. Uintah, maybe they've lost some big games, but have you seen a Uintah team quit?
Never.
And right this year, there's no quit to the final buzzer, even if the clock's running because the scores are run up so high. And then they want to take care of the ball and try to create turnovers on defense, the ever-critical turnover margin.
Yeah, that's the key, and most turnovers are caused by hard hitting and playing to the whistle, playing fair, but playing hard until the whistle blows.
Yeah, and then, so they said we need to win on third down on both offense and defense. And, and that's so critical. And that's actually one of the first times a coach this year is talking about winning on third down.
That, to me, first down and third down, those are the key.
Yeah,
and
if you get positive yards on first down.
That sets up third down. Second down is just another third down.
Sure. So then talking to Coach Austin Heaps for Uintah. And it's been the bane of this year, if you had any, is giving up the big play. And he says, let's not give up the big play this game.
A lot of times on big plays, that means you don't have the team speed as other teams. And that's when you see the big plays happen.
Yep. Somebody gets the edge or you get beat deep
right.
on a pass play. Right. They want to fire on all cylinders. And I think that, when you use a metaphor like that, firing on all cylinders – you know, you talk about the old V8s, and if your timing wasn't set right and you're only clicking on six of them, you know, that motor's worthless. And the Utes have so many options, and they're so good on so many different levels of football. But, you know, we've seen breakdowns in one or two of the areas, you know, this season a couple of times.
Yeah, and it's going to happen, especially when you're playing against good teams.
Yep. And his last thing is great line play. And I don't think, you know, when you think about what that offensive line's been asked to do, in almost every down, it's five down linemen. You know, Heaps has got so many options moving out. And those five guys have done a phenomenal job this year. Only a few times have they broken down and, you know, Henderson taking that big hit.
Right. Absolutely great job by offensive and defensive line this year.
Sure. So that's the coach speak here on VTV Channel 6. We're a few minutes away from the start of the game. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back in a minute.
Do you surf the net every time you shop? Well, forget the hard drive and make the short drive down to L&L. We have the best selection in the basin. At L&L, we're making the car buying experience all that it can be, because we're not here just to sell you a car. We're here to build a long, happy relationship. L&L Motor, people you know, people who care.
Surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uintah Basin.
It's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high-quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Come and see the professionals at Robinson Dental in Roosevelt. We specialize in cleaning, dental implants, whitening. Call us today and schedule your appointment. 435-725-3368.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6. Mark Mason, with me is Kevin Dixon. We're here at a great, we've got a great matchup tonight. We have the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons and the Uintah Utes here at Coach Belcher Stadium. Also want to thank everyone that's joining us on Spanish Fork 17 here on the live broadcast tonight. And just about to have the national anthem, and we'll let you enjoy that.
Thank you.
Well, good to see everyone standing for the national anthem. I know there's been some national controversy about that, but here in Vernal, Utah, it seems like everyone still enjoys the song the way it should be enjoyed. Kevin?
Yes, always a great job by the UNA Utes to start the game, including the national anthem.
Yes, so we saw the starting lineup for the Dons. Well, at least the kicking team was out on the field, and the Utes look like they're going to kick off, so they'll have the first possession of the second half, but the Dons will start tonight's game receiving the ball in the north end zone, and it's a beautiful fall night of football. Kickoff temperature about 50 degrees right now, and if there's a breeze, I can't tell.
No, yeah. It's perfect football weather.
Yeah, this is the nights where everything just feels great. So in to kick for the Utes will be number 12, Trevin McCackney, the senior, and he is a weapon on special teams. The tactical advantage to have a touchback on almost every kickoff is just unbelievable.
Yeah, I mean, he has just really developed as a kicker these last couple of years.
Yeah, and last year was his first year playing mm-hmm. football. He split time, and McCackney is a natural soccer player, which fits on the kicking game for football. And there's the kick, and he's going to put that one. Well, that one lands at about the 3-yard line. So to return for Spanish Fork is number 12, Stanton. And Stanton gets to about where he would have been had it been a touchback. He does advance it to the 22-yard line, where the Dons will set up shop on their first possession. So decent kick and decent coverage on that kick. And here we go.
You know, that's one of the things the next level looks at is the hang time, not only the distance, but the hang time. Great hang time on that kick.
Yeah, you get it up there and let your coverage team get down there. So in for the quarterback is Carson Chappelle. Chappelle looking to pass, looks left side, goes deep, has a man with a step, and does not get Jackson Higginson, overthrows Jackson, and in on the coverage, I believe, was Brakefield, number 5, Dustin Brakefield, was it?
Looks like oh. Tien.
Oh,
so Cameron Peterson.
Yeah, Cameron Peterson, yeah. I looked at the wrong level of the secondary. It was Cameron Peterson, number 10, and Cameron is a senior for the Utes. And the way the Ute defensive scheme is, a lot of one-on-one. You know, those defensive backs are on an island all night long. So again, to pass, looking to the – oh, a nice spin move, and with some speed gives – oh, I think he's gone. It's number 2, Jackson Higginson, and that's just a quick out, and you talk about team speed. He catches, spins, and then sprints – And what a play. Oh, my goodness. That is a 78-yard touchdown pass.
You know, he made a nice move the play before that moved, or it didn't get there, but he made a nice move to get open the play before. That time he just made a nice move and got in the open field and was able to outrun everybody.
So Chappelle hits on his second throw, 1 for 2 on the night, and has 78 yards. And a nice catch and run by Jackson Higginson. Just spin move. And that's where, if you're on an island, if you don't make that contact, it's gone. So in for the two-point conversion at this point, thrown to the corner and then defended. And I believe that was Mike Jones.
Mike Jones, great job. Good recovery on that. Good pursuit by the defensive line of the Utes to force him to throw that a little bit early. The pass was actually nice, just a great play by Jones to break it up.
So a designed play, it looks like, Noah Conway. And he's trying to hit James Daw, and Jones just runs and knocks the football down. No good. So with that, the Dons lead 6-0, and we'll kick off. And, wow, that happened quick.
About not the way you want to start a ball game, but the Utes get the ball, and we'll see if they can drive.
So there you see on the monitor, Spanish Fork, offensive line coach talking about, you know, what do we need to do? What are the strategies here? Coach them up, coach. And the Utes to receive. And back to receive is number 1, Dallin Brakefield. He sets up at about the 4-yard line. The Brakefield brothers have been just a revelation this year.
Yeah, I mean, they have both played well both sides of the ball, including special teams.
Here's a little pooch kick going to be caught at the 33-yard line and up advanced about a 9-yard return to the 42-yard line of the Utes. And I didn't see who the ball carrier was. 32 was Brandon Giles. He's a junior for the Utes.
You know, that's a great job because you're not used to getting the ball. He knew exactly what to do with it. Ended up with a great return on a short kick. Puts the Utes in great field position.
And not only that, I think this is a coach moment. He had both hands covering the ball.
Yes. Yeah, so
he understands this isn't my job, but I have both hands covering the ball, advances at 9 yards. Henderson in shotgun looks to the left side. Henderson throws. It's high and caught by Dallin Brakefield, crosses midfield to the 40 of the Dons.
You know, that's a great concentration to go up in the air. You know you're going to get hit hard, which he was.
So you
and
see
concentrates
here,
and catches the ball.
Right here on the L&L motor replay. Oof. When you go up like that and you're in the middle of the field, the first thing you think about is my ribs. In on the tackle is Zach Buse. There's a handoff to Jones. Jones goes up to about the 39-yard line. They mark him down at the 40. So picks up 4 on first down.
And that's a good first down play for the Utes.
Yeah, you just give it to your sledgehammer. You know, and those up the middle runs pay off in the fourth quarter. So here's it looks like an option play. Goes left side. Henderson hit as he pitches. Gets it to Walters. Walters, boy, just turns his legs. He should have been down at the 40, and somehow he takes the pile to the 35-yard line.
You know, it was a great adjustment to the ball by Walters. Pitch a little behind him. A lot of times you just keep trying to run, but he does a good job to make sure he doesn't turn it over and then gets what he can out of it and just churns and churns.
And you see Ermston. I mean, Ermston was on him at the 40, and you just keep those legs moving. So Henderson from shotgun. Henderson hands off to Jones. Jones makes the first tackler miss, has the first down, and he gets pushed out of bounds at the 25-yard line. That is a misdirection play. Everything shifts to the right, and they hand off left.
Go misdirection. You get some over pursuit right there.
Yeah,
Jones has the speed to break it outside. Great angle by number 25.
That's Ermston.
Bronson Ermston.
So here's a screen pass, and that does not do well. And in on the pressure again was Gavin Campbell, number 55. He has been in Henderson's personal space rearranging the kitchen appliances 2 plays in a row now. And he's just pursuing quarterback. I think his job is quarterback, so. Looking for a pass. There's the throw. It's at the sideline, caught by Corbin Allen, out of bounds about the 32-yard line. So picks up 3, brings up 3rd and 7.
That's a good job. You get about half of it, and it sets up so 3rd down is a doable play.
McCackney has the leg to kick from here, so the Utes in scoring position right now. So Henderson in kind of that pistol formation, Jones behind him. Henderson hands off to Jones. Jones pushes. He's at the 20, the 19-yard line. Going to be about 5 yards short of the first down. That's a delayed handoff, and it's just a read by the quarterback.
A little bit of a draw. Get good yardage, and this is when it's hard to be a head coach, but it does look like he is going to go for the field goal.
So McCackney coming in, and he's kicking from the left hash. His preference is the right hash, and he won the first game of the season against Snow Canyon from the right hash, but here on the left hash, lines it up. In on the hold, Cruz Leyba. Pressure from the Dons. Kick looks up, and it's got the distance, and it's good.
It's good. That's a great job to come from the left hash. Can't say enough about him.
So that's a 38-yard field goal for McCackney, and the Utes on the board. So an impressive first drive starting deep in their territory, and came up a little bit short on the last down, but make a field goal about McCackney, and off we go. Tonight's game brought to us by L&L Motor. L&L Motor is the number one rated new car dealer in the basin. Visit our new Buick GMC full-service store in Vernal.
So both offenses get it rolling at the beginning.
Yeah, and that's that critical first possession.
Yes.
Know?
And, I mean, obviously important to score on your first drive, but then to answer back, even if it was a field goal, extremely important.
So 6-3 with the missed point after attempt. Failed two-point conversion, I should say. McCackney lines up to kick. McCackney hits that one low and long. Caught it about the 2-yard line. Stanton hit at the 20-yard line and then just gets rocked by number 43, Hunter Wheeler.
You know, and Hunter's just been playing great defense all year. Great job on special teams. Looks like Peterson was the first one, I think, to make contact with him down the field. Once again, good coverage by the Utes. It's just about where they got it the last time, I believe.
So the Dons start on the 22-yard line. Right, Peterson stands him up, and then Wheeler just – and you know there's no better feeling. You're the first guy back in the huddle after a play like that. So second possession for the Dons from shotgun. It's a handoff up the middle, number 34, Lomax. And Lomax gets to about the 28, and they mark him down there at the 28-yard line.
And a great first down call. You've passed twice the first one. First one you got, almost scored a touchdown. Second one you did. And you come back with the run and get a great, great yardage on first down.
And you look at the playmakers on the field, sophomore and juniors for the Dons. So from shotgun, Stanton, handoff again up the middle. They're just going to keep going right there. Looks like he has enough yardage for the first down. They do indeed mark him down at the 32-yard line. That'll advance the sticks.
Looks like Jacoby Mold on the hit that time. Great job from his defensive line position to slow him down. And again, that second down play was set up by a great first down play.
So the Dons' play calling has been pretty simple. Pass left, run middle, run middle. And I think sometimes you get lulled to sleep when you're out there on the defensive side. It hasn't come to you to the right side, and so that's something to watch for. So there's a pass to the right side, and he's got a step on him, and it's caught by number 34, Lomax, taken down by number 20. And number 20 is Sterling Tomeno, saves a touchdown. It was not Lomax. It was number 24, Sa'ali. And Sa'ali looks like he has a little bit of a gimpy right leg coming off the field, left leg actually. So, wow, look at the touch on this ball, Kevin.
Yeah, that is a great pass, and again, a great call coming off a play action where they just had two successful runs, play action, and they were able to throw it deep.
And that was one of the rare cases where they had over-the-top help from the safety, and both of them got beat deep there, so... Chappelle goes to the corner. He has a man open. It's Stanton. Stanton catches the ball, and it is a touchdown. So Chappelle, this time from about the 18-yard line, just goes left corner and puts up a nice ball.
Sees a man open and just throws a nice ball that's easy to catch.
And I didn't see from the opening snap. You know, Dustin Brakefield had to come from a long distance away.
I would think that's a blown coverage, which Brakefield did a nice job. But, again, that was a nice touch pass. He just threw it up, so it was an easy catch.
Chappelle's second touchdown throw of the night, and that's a point after that is good by James Daw. He is one of the few seniors that plays significant minutes for the Dons, so. So 13-3. Boy, I'm just butchering that score.
Those missed extra points. Yeah. They're killers.
Chappelle with the pass to Stanton. And so the Utes with the opportunity for their second possession of the game, looking to build on the successful first drive. And we've had one pooch kick. And that serves notice to the front five on the return team. Be prepared for anything. That ball could come at you or go over. And the Utes, the way they set up, have brought most of the return team inside the, you know, north of the 20-yard line. So they, or, you know, something says these are usually short kicks, and so that's a short kick going to be fielded at the 9-yard line. Up through and has some rooms, spins, and then tackled at the 35-yard line was Dallin Bragfield.
So once again, special teams kick return sets up the offense in great field position.
Yeah, you had the first drive start on the 42-yard line. Now this drive on the 35-yard line. And, you know, that 15, 20 yards just means.
Yeah, it
means so much for a team. Henderson, shotgun. Jones in the backfield. Motion man is Leyba. Hand off to Leyba. Leyba cuts it up inside. And that's a nice run by Cruz Leyba. You know, and Cruz is not big by stature, but has a ginormous heart.
Yeah, he weighs 250 pounds. Unfortunately, about 175 is heart.
Yeah, so that kid running up the middle, I asked him about that, and he says he likes – I asked him, edge or middle? And he said middle. So take that. Jones with a stiff arm. Jones up to the 45-yard line, maybe a half yard short of the first down.
So the Utes doing a good job controlling the ball. I mean, big down right here. We talked about third down. Here's a big one.
Watch this replay. Jones, there's the stiff arm. And that's what gets him the extra 5 yards. And look at the power running by Jones. Just Nate Mattis holding on for dear life. And, you know, 3 yards after contact.
And that's what you need to do. Big, powerful back.
So Walters, Jones in the backfield. Walters, the up back. It's a blown play. Henderson looks to Walters, has the first down, and Moore across the 50-yard line. Has blockers in front, still on his feet at the 29-yard line.
I'll tell you, that's a great job downfield by Corbin Allen. Just security didn't go for a big hit. He just got in the way and actually were able to add about 6 or 7. See, you look at that, and it really looked like a broken play, but I'm not sure if it was.
So there's the blocking upfield and
Brakefield, again, another – good job downfield making sure you don't get the holder.
Hand off to Walters. Walters hit at about the 24-yard line and stacked up by a host of Dons. In on the tackle was Lofton, also number 55, Gavin Campbell.
Great job by Murray leading the way on the blocking downfield. Anytime you see him driving a man down that far, you know your lineman's doing what they're supposed to.
Ute's going a little old school with some of this power running up the middle. Henderson in the shotgun. Henderson looks to pass, has the slant open. Oh, and it's picked off by the outside linebacker coming back the other way. Hit, and he's at the 50 and tackled by Walters at the 43-yard line. That was number 21, Nate Mattis, and he just stepped in front of that throw. You'll see on the L&L Motor replay, he's just setting up on that outside. And it looks like that ball might have come out of Henderson's hand just a little bit. And then a big return after the interception.
You know, again, that's just standing where you're supposed to be. He wasn't in no man's land. He was going to help with that, was back there for the pass, and just stepped right in front and made the pick.
So that starts the Dons' third possession of the game at the Ute 43-yard line. Looking to pass, going deep. Has a man open, caught. That's Jackson Higginson again, just on one-on-one coverage against Cameron Peterson. Big throw.
And that is a great job by the receiver. He just uses his body, shields it, concentrates, because it's good coverage right there. A little bit of a push, but not enough to call.
And those balls.
That is great concentration. Looks like we are going to bring it back, though.
So most likely a holding penalty. Did you see the call?
Looks like a P.I.,
pass interference. Okay, so maybe got called on that push off.
Yeah, it might have been. I didn't see where the flag was upfield a little bit, so
back it goes, and these are spot of the foul, or is that a 15 yard penalty?
It's 15 from the line of scrimmage.
Yep. Okay, so
for offensive, and it used to be when I coached, it was also loss of down, which was a real killer.
So remains first down, first in a bunch, 25 yards to go. Handoff up the middle, tackled after about a 4-yard gain. They'll give him 2 on that carry. Advances it to the 44-yard line.
Good job by the Ute defense. I mean, first and long, I do like a running play there, and the Utes were there ready to stop. But great call, and the Utes stayed home, did what they were supposed to.
So brings up second and seems like forever from the 44-yard line. Looking to pass, tucks it down, doesn't see like what he sees on that slant pass, and just dives forward for 5 yards, and that's just intelligent football.
It is. I mean, you don't throw a pick there. You still have the ball around midfield. No reason to give it up there. Great decision, and he turned in some yards. Foster, great job by the Utes. Alex making the tackle on that.
So after the first turnover of the game, the Dons advance the ball on a deep pass. Penalty pushes them back. Brings up third and 20. Back to pass, looking left side, lofting it up again. Good coverage by the Utes this time. The ball's caught. Did he?
No, he's made,
okay, and they call him out of bounds. And the intended receiver was Stanton. And look at the coverage on this. Yeah. This is going to be covered by Dallin Brakefield. And Dallin, no, excuse me, it's Tomano. No, number 10.
Peterson,
yep. And there's a ball caught. Ooh. Oh, it hits the turf.
Yeah, that's actually a great call. But oh, my goodness, what great concentration.
He actually had a foot in and had the ball. Dodging a bullet.
I'll tell you, what a receiver.
Yeah, wow. What a quarterback.
Great job by Peterson. I mean, you can't cover any better than that, and he still catches the ball.
Looking, going to punt with the left foot, rugby style. That ball's at the 2-yard line, and boy, on the coverage was Stanton, and he almost downed it. No, it wasn't Stanton. It was number 42, Riley Hess, nearly downed it at the 2-yard line.
I'll tell you, that's a great kick.
Well, and they bought time. He rolls to his left. He's going to kick it rugby style. And you know, even though doesn't have great loft, that delayed action is what allowed the coverage team to get down there, nearly down it at the 2-yard line. So the penalty ends up killing that drive after the turnover, so no points scored after the turnover. And there you see the Ute fans. And are the cheers the same? Were they the same in your high school days as mine?
No.
They do the same things that I did, and that was in 1993, so... I just wonder if they come up with new things or not.
Yeah, in 1975, they were different.
Stacked up at the 20-yard line. No gain on first down. And Henderson was given some instructions. So he obviously thought something different should have happened on that play. But second and 10, Henderson in the backfield. Henderson is shotgun. Henderson looking to the left side, throws, caught. That's at about the 26-yard line. I didn't see who the receiver was.
That's Corbin. A great play. It looks like Henderson is down.
Corbin Allen and Henderson, we'll see on the replay. So he's standing tall here, and he throws. Oh, and just somebody rolled into him. And so he has to come off the field because they did call that injury timeout. And it's just one of those... a guy who goes down being blocked and rolls into Henderson's knee. So coming in, I'm sure, is going to be Franks, right? Is it Brody Franks who's going to sub here?
Let's see.
I can't see from
looks yet.
It should
Oaks.
Be.
Looks like Oaks. I think Franks is injured.
Franks had hand surgery. There's a handoff to Walters. Walters gets to the 26-yard line where he's stacked up pretty handily by Nate Mattis. Well, I undetermined who the quarterback was. Do you think it was
Oaks. It's Cameron, who is a great quarterback. Uh-huh. Coaching or playing with the JV team.
Is that Dagan Oaks?
Yes.
So now, after three straight runs, well, there was a pass in there. Three and out. Ooh, boy. McCackney just does get it away. Fair caught at the 43-yard line by the Dons. And so they do mark it at the 44-yard line.
And so starting off with offense and defense, both do a great job that last series.
Access live game coverage on the latest smartphones and mobile devices from Strata Networks. Choose the best devices from your favorite brands and pay nothing down with Strata Plus. Stop by a Strata store in Roosevelt or Vernal to find out more. Shotgun, Chappelle. Chappelle hands off up the middle. Nice move to the left and gains about. Oh, and that was a nice dive. Got an extra 2 or 3 yards. Tackler was Jones, I believe.
I'll tell you, Sam Daw for the Dons makes a great block to get that play going.
Boy, you look at that juke inside out. Walters bites on it, and then Jones goes down low.
Good job by Brakefield. Actually made good contact with the ball. Great job to hang on to it.
So second and short, Chappelle from shotgun. And there's an offside. Looks like Jones is the guilty party.
I think that's
going to
be on offense.
Oh, and they do call a false start. Second penalty of the game for the Dons. None for the Utes. So the Dons have 15 yard or 20 yards in penalties, and one of them was a costly one.
Yeah, and this one, even though it's 5 yards, second and 7 is sure different than second and 2.
So, surveying the field, Carson Chappelle, the junior for the Dons. He's looking to the left side. He throws, and it's caught by number 1, Colt Condy. Condy has the first down yardage and then gets run out of bounds by number 10, Cameron Peterson.
Good job by Peterson. Got off his feet a little bit, came up, made an adjustment, made the tackle. And again, after the catch, great move to get some extra yards. But good recovery by Peterson right there.
So the passing game doing very well for the Dons. Chappelle's going to hand off up the middle this time. And boy, that's just an open field tackle. And you have number 32, Brandon Giles. He's playing on that left end. And he sits and waits for the handoff and then just attacks the ball carrier.
That's great vision. Saw the hole, filled it.
So that brings up second and 11 after the first down catch by Condy. Chappelle, shotgun again. Has Lomax back. He goes left side. He pump fakes, and he gets the pass out. That's caught by Higginson. Higginson out of bounds about the 37-yard line. They call it the 36. And he's going to be about a yard short of the first down. Critical third down for the Ute defense right here.
And we're probably looking at 2 down here. So, and the Utes starting to put a little more pressure on the quarterback. We'll see if that can continue. Threw it a little bit quicker than he wanted to.
So a big cushion here with third and short. Peterson giving a big cushion. They do hand it off up the middle, and he gets the first down. That's Lomax, the ball carrier, and spins his way to about the 31-yard line.
Great vision to find the hole, and good job by Brakefield to come in and make a sure tackle in the hole. You know, anytime you see a back, he got the first down first and then look for extra yardage. That's a well-coached running back.
Well, that's the end of the first quarter here at Coach Belcher Stadium, home of the Utes. We're on VTV Channel 6. We'll be right back.
Do you surf the net every time you shop? Well, forget the hard drive and make the short drive down to L&L. We have the best selection in the basin. At L&L, we're making the car buying experience all that it can be, because we're not here just to sell you a car. We're here to build a long, happy relationship. L&L Motor, people you know, people who care.
Here at VTV Channel 6, Mark Mason, Kevin Dixon, voting season, Kevin. I know you're running for school board this year. After a long, healthy career, you couldn't get out, huh?
No, couldn't get out.
Yeah, so wish you luck in that.
Well, I appreciate that.
Had an interesting night, school board meeting where they let you and the other candidates share your opinions. And I rather enjoyed that experience. That's probably as intimate as I've got with the election process, and it was pretty neat to see the different opinions out there.
You know, the thing when you look at especially local elections, I don't care if it's school board, county commissioner, those tend to be the people who care the most, I think, about actually doing things good for the community.
Indeed. So get out and vote is the message. And here on the replay, you're going to see a nice pass to Chappelle. And he just hits Colt Condi, who's a senior. And Colt's just dancing left, right, and then just explodes and nearly loses the football. Look at how dangerous he's holding it. Oh, it was so close to a fumble. And, boy, he reached up with the left hand and just did secure it. Colt Condi picked up the first down. So the Dons in business at the 18-yard line. Swing out to Conway. Conway gets the edge. Conway looks like, oh, and he runs into two or three Utes. And I believe it was 32 for the Utes. That's Brandon Giles that saved the touchdown at about the 3-yard line.
That was good job switching speed. Looked like he was going to get stopped and just turned on the speed.
Well, here's the pitch, and it's going to go out Conway. He's got a host of blockers out in front of him, and there's a little bit of a hold there.
Not a little bit.
Yeah,
that's a full
fistful of shirt brought to you by L&L Motor Replay. So from the 3-yard line, handoff, it goes right up the middle, and that's an easy score for Mateen Lomax. And Lomax, after a lot of work this evening, gets to the pay dirt for the first time, takes the score to 19-3.
So Spanish Forks, their offense has been on a roll.
Indeed. There was a couple of punts on each side. And then here they answer with a big long drive. And there's a low kick. Foster's going to get the block. But all he did was get his foot in the way of it.
Great job busting through the line. We'll see if we can see that again. I mean, that's a big kid.
Yeah. We were talking about him in the break. He's a sophomore, and he's probably the biggest player on both sides. And Foster gets through there, and if it's not low, he blocks it anyway.
Yeah. One of the most important aspects of injury or
didn't look like it was going to make it anyway.
Ashley Regional has two great orthopedic surgeons, Dr. Burke Young, who has years of experience, and Dr. Adam Madsen, new to Ashley Regional.
But not new to Vernal.
No. Adam was the quarterback for you in a high school during his high school years. You probably had some coaching moments with that young man.
Yeah, I absolutely did. I like to look at Adam. He was more of a linebacker, too. I was a defensive coach. But, yeah, Adam, both sides of the ball. You know, it's just one of those, a great athlete and just a great kid who I am sure has grown up to be a great man. And then, of course, what can we say about Doc Young?
Yeah,
I guess it runs in the family between those two.
Another short kick fielded by Leyba. Leyba runs it up to about the 37-yard line, and he is brought down by 4 or 5 Dons. And Leyba having somewhat of a quiet night. We've only called his number a couple of times.
And once again, the kick return team sets up the offense in nice field position.
So starting this time from the 37-yard line, the Utes have had good field position on all of their drives. The worst was the 20-yard line after the touchback on the punt. And so switch at quarterback, thrown out, caught by Dallin Brakefield. And so you do see the quarterback is Dagan Oaks, number 13, and he's a sophomore, so... And his first pass of the night was a good one, 6 yards on first down. They give him 5, it looks like, on the spot. Brings up second. And that slant play for the Utes has been successful all season. Oaks throws back. It's going to be caught by Peterson. Peterson makes the first guy miss and then gets bumped out of bounds by number 21, Nate Mattis.
So great catch. I believe that's Allen, isn't it?
Yeah, Corbin Allen.
Corbin number Allen. 11. Great. Mm-hmm. And Oaks, great job. Great job setting that up, looking off.
And, boy, that's just heads-up awareness. And did you see the hurdle move to make the diving Colt Condi miss? Corbin Allen coming to life this year. He's a junior. So there's a handoff up the middle. Walter shrugs off the first tackler, gets the 49-yard line.
And a decent first down.
So right at midfield, second and eight for the Utes. And the quarterback switch here. Henderson had that player roll up on his ankle. And so the sophomore rolling out to his right has a man
great
open.
Great touch.
Walters.
Oh,
Walters
great move by
through.
Walters.
And then he's brought down. The first one there was number 50, Harmon, for the Dons. And that brings the crowd to life for the Utes.
I'll tell you, very impressed with Oaks coming in and moving the team.
You know, we talked to Austin Heaps at VTV6 in the studios for the Sports Spin, and he talked about the quarterback play and getting these quarterbacks to get the right protections, the right calls at the line. And Oaks, as a sophomore, certainly seems to be doing that right now.
He does. And, you know, great offensive play calling right now. They're giving him great opportunities with short passes, gets him confidence, and he is gaining the confidence in a hurry.
So Oaks in shotgun has Jones and Walters in the backfield with him, three receivers out. Looks to pass, has a man on the edge, and just throws it out of the reach of, I believe it was Dustin Brakefield. Yeah, so if you like sports, if you like high school sports in the Uintah Basin, check out VTV6's new show, The Sports Spin. In its second season, have player and coach interviews each week, highlights from games of the week like this one. So, and it'll air 6:30 on VTV Channel 6. You can catch replays on their VTVChannel6.com. And you can vote for your favorite play of the week and amongst other things. There's a handoff. It's kind of a end around from Brakefield. And there's not a lot of room, so he dives forward but only gets about a yard, brings up fourth and about three.
It looks like the Utes are going to go for it.
At this point in the game, you're down 19-3. There's 9 minutes left in the second quarter. Either you go for it or you put up the white flag.
Yep.
So there's a handoff, Jones with the first down, and Jones, he uses that deceptive speed, and I'm telling you right now, there is a little bit of extracurricular going on the field. So watch here on the L&L Motor Replay. Jones gets this, and bam! He hits that corner so fast, and he's up north and south running as soon as he made the edge. Wow. That's just impressive running from the big fella.
You know, watching Oaks, what I really like what he's doing is what he's doing when he gets rid of the ball. Great job. You didn't really know that he'd given it off.
Ooh, and that's just a play where neither Walters and fortunately number 20, Zach Buse, knew the ball was in the air.
Yeah.
Because number 20 for the Dons, if he'd have known that ball was in the air, that could have been an easy pick. Yeah, and you talk about that play action – you know, from Oaks on the run by Jones, you're right. He tucked and ran like he really did have the football.
You know, and those are the things you look at. If a kid believes he's in,
ooh, what an open field tackle.
Play.
That's number 24, Sa'ali. And he was on an island. If he misses, this
yeah, it's six.
Yeah. And there's the pass, and it's Walters, and hit as he catched by Leota Sa'ali. And, wow, that's defense. So third and about 12. They can't get a first down without scoring here. Oaks, shotgun, has Jones. Four receivers, three to the right, looking left. Steps up in the pocket, has a little bit of time, throws back to his left. It's a laser, caught by Leba. Leba scores.
I'll tell you, that is great job by both the receiver, the quarterback, and the lineman. Lineman is so disciplined not to go downfield on this. Okay, watch Reynolds right there. Great job with two people. Very close to stepping over. And then just great vision.
And he threw a dart.
Yeah,
that's a across your body laser to Leyba. And going for it on fourth down. And the ball's fumbled by Leyba. And Leyba is going to be taken down by a host of Dons. So the Utes with their own failed extra point conversion. And the ball just seemed like it was a low snap and it skipped across the grass. So there brings the score 19-9. But I want to go back to that touchdown. And we can bring up that L&L motor replay. And you watch, and it's not just the quarterback play, but watch the offensive line.
Watch Reynolds. 1-2. He is containing two right there.
And they keep hitting and they keep blocking until that ball is out of there. And that's a five-second pocket.
Right. And then Cruz Leyba does a great job. Find an opening, give your quarterback a good target, make yourself visible.
So the Utes score here and make it a ball game. Now 19-9. The missed PATs could cost both teams as the game winds down. So to kick it is McCackney. Boy, that offensive line, that was impressive.
That was.
It is so difficult to maintain to block for that long.
And then not to go downfield on something that could have been. There's a
touchback
kick that we're used to.
Yeah, the first touchback of the game for both teams, and McCackney hits that one 3 yards deep. And so the Dons are going to set up at the 20-yard line. You know, the NFL this year changed that, so if it's a touchback, it goes to the 25-yard line. Still. Almost everyone that goes in the end zone, they run back. So
yep.
I don't know.
I mean, you're talking professional athletes. Give me the ball.
Yeah. Every one of them's going back.
It's like
for a
asking
score.
A professional baseball player, do you want to be intentionally walked? No, thank you. Yeah. I'll run it. Thank you.
I want to swing. So high snap, handoff. Good blocking by the Dons. Gets passed and taken down by Dustin Brakefield. And wow, he was 10 yards down before there was any threat of a tackle. Watch this cut, and boy, big blocks, although that's an illegal block.
Jerome Jones, great blocking.
And Brakefield comes and tackles, and in with him was Cameron Peterson, I believe. Might have been Tomato, Sterling Tomato, number 20. Handoff again, Lomax. Lomax not nearly successful this time. Brought down this time by Corbin Allen.
That's a great job by the Ute defensive line. Second a little bit longer this time.
Manage the down and distance as a defense. Don't give them easy first downs. From the shotgun, Chappelle. Chappelle, another high snap. Handoff again. Oh, boy.
Off the top.
And it's just wide open after he gets through the line. And Sterling Tamano with the tackle. But the blocking on the offensive line for the Dons created a monster hole again for Lomax. You see him cut through. I could have drove my pickup truck through that. And Walters tries the shoulder tackle, and that's going to cost you if you don't wrap up. Four yards back, Chappelle, shotgun. Handoff again. Why not? It's working. And this time, it's not working. And in on the tackle, host of Utes, including Hunter Wheeler and also number 57, Alex Foster.
That's a great job. The one thing I'm a little bit worried about, looks like the Utes are not covering trips. They have an extra man out there, and the Utes are bringing the outside linebacker in. So hopefully they'll adjust to that.
And so far with the run after run after run.
Right.
Call.
I mean, you understand why, because you have to stop the run.
So here's the trips to the left side of the offensive formation.
Okay, there.
And there's the linebacker cheating up. And this time he stays at home. They've got a deep pass. Brakefield
Oh, no! Brakefields! He breaks it up, but then it's bouncing in the air, and Stanton just keeps his eyes on it and catches that ball and runs it in for a touchdown. Oh, you couldn't ask for a better play from Brakefield. Yep. He sees that ball up in the air and hit as he's trying to catch it, and Stanton juggles and bobbles and then takes it in and just waltzes into the end zone.
I mean, Brakefield has great coverage from the very beginning of that play. A nice thrown ball, but oh my goodness, what a catch. What a game he has been having.
So the Dons answer, and then they get a two-point conversion, and the ball carrier on the two-point conversion is number 8, Noah Conway. He had the first failed one, but this time was successful. So that takes the score 27-9, and the Dons answer quickly.
You know, offensively, they are clicking. Running, passing, anything they want to do, they seem to be doing it right now.
Boy, and that bobble catch, Stanton. Yep. I mean, here you see this. Here's Chappelle, and he throws it. It's a bad decision.
I mean, Brakefield is in great position the entire time, and the thing that helps is the ball's a little bit underthrown. And you see that when a ball's underthrown, the receiver's able to come back and make a play. If that ball's thrown perfectly, Brakefield picks.
So now the Dons in to kick. Moon Lake Electric has been in operation since 1938. Owned by the people they serve, Moon Lake is a cooperative, not privately owned. Find and like Moon Lake on Facebook and tell them thanks for helping VTV6 bring you tonight's game. So, wow. They're good and lucky. The Dons take the score 27-9. Another short kick. It's going to hit the turf and then bounce forward. It is a live ball picked up finally by Brakefield, who just gets about 2 yards on the return. And, boy, that's a dangerous thing when that ball bounces at the 17-yard line like that.
Yeah, he was anticipating that ball bouncing a little bit further where it just died.
So the Utes, second time they've set up on the 20-yard line. The first go-around it ended up in a punt. But the offense looked good on the last drive. They took the ball from their 37-yard line with a nice 73-yard scoring drive. 63-yard scoring drive, excuse me. Staying with Oaks at quarterback. Oaks throws outside.
Good timing.
Leyba, trying to get around and just steps, plants that foot out of bounds. And that's too bad because he did it just a yard short of the first down.
A good first down.
And everybody fooled on the play action. And Oaks doing a great job of selling the handoff and then sprinting to the right side. And I thought he was just going to maintain it, and then he ended up throwing.
And it's an option what he has.
Boy, look at that. And it's another great play fake, and Jones just doing work across the 50-yard line down at the 47.
Okay, watch a great job by Brakefield blocking downfield. Again, just get in the way of the defensive back, the safety, and he really aids Jones in this.
Jones makes the first tackler miss, and then you see the downfield blocking.
See, look at that right there. Just guide right with him.
That's at least 10 yards of extra field position for the blocking downfield. There's a fumbled handoff kicked by the Dons. They're trying to get it, and it's on the ground, and then they're going to be down at the 30-yard line. And, that's just too bad. And the recovery was Gavin Campbell. And Oaks is trying to read, and that's that delayed handoff. And when he pulls it out.
Yeah, the ball's just low.
Oh, yeah, it was a bad snap and catch.
Then got kicked.
Yeah, and that was Campbell that kicked it and then recovered it. So the Dons setting up at the 30-yard line. So second turnover of the game for the Utes from the 30-yard line, waiting for the referee to signal that they're ready. Chappelle pitches out. Ball carrier is Conway. Conway cuts it up. Conway at the 25, the 20. There's going to be a holding penalty at the 30-yard line.
So good job by the Utes stringing that out.
So there's the penalty. We'll wait for the official call, but it had to be holding on the wing.
Or a push in the back, but something is – that's what sprung it.
There's the holding call from the referee. And so back they go. It'll be 10 yards and put them back the 29-yard line. So these are spot of the infraction fouls. Since the holding occurred at the 29-yard line, 10-yard penalty, but it was 1 yard after the line of scrimmage. Okay. Chappelle, shotgun. Chappelle, kind of a somewhat blown play and then taken down after 4 yardage of about 5 yards. And who was the tackler? Number 66?
Like, yep, I believe that's who it was.
And that's Jacoby Mold.
Great job by Mold.
Wheeler in on the tackle as well. Brings up third and long, about 17 on the after the penalty. And so if the Utes can avoid two times in a row over turnovers, that's a win for the defense. Giving up short fields and not giving up points, this critical third down is the key. Probably two down territory. Yeah. It's hard to punt from the 37-yard
line. Try to get half of it.
Wow, Stanton wishes he had that one back. It was a low pass, hit him about where his knees were, but he did it. My coaches always tell me, if you can put hands on the ball, you can catch it. So Stanton on a rare miscue between he and Chappelle. Fourth down, and they indeed leave the offense on the field. What's there to gain on a punt there? Most likely it's going into the end zone.
Yeah, unless if you have a punter who's incredible, who can pin him inside.
Timeout on the field. We'll take a timeout here on VTV6. We'll be right back.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6. Nice sideline view of the Don sidelines. You see the huddle over there. And it's a third, well, they have it marked
they
as a third
down. They
have
it marked third, unless if they had it mismarked earlier. It was third before, and maybe.
Okay, so something changed. We went to a break with a fourth down marker. They switch it to a third down marker. It's third and 16 is based on where the ball is on the field. Chappelle in shotgun. Chappelle looking left side, goes to the right side, has a man open. It's caught. And it's Stanton. Stanton trying to get to the first down marker, and he's about a yard short, but that's a big-time play on third and long.
Again, just squat around the first down marker, and the pass is right there.
And that's just, wow, I'm impressed with Chappelle. That's a look-off, and you don't see a lot of that on the prep level. You know, he looked left knowing he was going right the whole time. Chappelle.
Look for a quarterback keeper here, I would think.
Has five receivers three to the left. Here comes the motion man in the middle. It's going to be a quarterback keeper. It was not Chappelle, and you're right. It was.
I don't think he got it.
Conway and the official lineman says down at the 22-yard line.
I'll tell you, that's Walters with a great play. Walters anticipated, watched him the full way. Comes in and denies him.
And that's just where they get the spread offense. You have five guys in, and the only thing they bring in, you know, the motion man was, what, number 24, and he brought an extra defender in there.
Yeah.
And that's maybe what clogged that
up.
Yeah,
sometimes I don't understand motion when you motion to a play.
There's a handoff.
Oh, there's a great.
Boy, Walters. Just rumbling and stumbling up to the 47-yard line.
I'll tell you, this is a big series for the Utes if they want to get back in the ballgame.
So we call that a turnover on downs for the Dons. And the Utes start on their 22-yard line on a first down play, move it all the way up to the 46-yard line with a big run from Dorian Walters. Low snap. Oh, and it's just over Leyva's head. That's too bad. Leyva had 5 yards on the
Yeah, it would have been a nice pickup. Pretty long pass across the field and just over his head.
So that's the first turnover of the game on the turnover on downs for the Dons. And the Utes on both turnovers, the defense was up to the challenge. Oaks hands off to Jones. Jones on the right edge. Jones at the 50.
Good vision.
Oh, and just tackled. And that, if it doesn't save a touchdown, it saves 20 yards.
Right.
That is a crazy good ankle tackle. Jones making that upfield turn. Brings up third and two. I didn't see who the tackler was. Oaks. Oaks hands off to Jones. Jones
gets through.
And it was not Jones. It was Walters. Walters picks up the first down from a nice block from Jones, the lead blocker in that case. And you watch this, and here comes Jones, and there's the kick-out block right there. He just springs that run.
Great job. Good job by the offensive line, too. Great position.
Wow. He hit Ermston and stacked him up 6 yards backwards. A little cross run, and Walters hit by number 21, Mattis, and driven backwards 5 yards. And those are the neck cracker type tackles.
Yeah, that was a just perfect form tackling.
So second and 11. Utes on the Dons 40-yard line. Oaks has Jones in the backfield. There's a handoff to Jones. Jones sheds the first tackler and gets to back what would be the original line of scrimmage. Brings up third and 10.
And again, we're in two down territory. So get at least half of it here.
Boy, on that play, Cruz Leyva was in the slot, and he took a step backwards and was wide open. There was nobody there. Oaks looking to the right side, throws. That ball is tipped and nearly intercepted. And he just threw it into a spot.
Yeah, a little bobble on the snap just kind of threw the play off.
Looking over and throws, and Stanton nearly picks it up off the turf. Fourth down, and McCackney on the punt.
Yeah, and my guess is this is not going to be a punt, but we'll see.
So from the 40-yard line, and the Dons looking like they're going to play protection. Oh, and there's a spiral kick. It's going to land at the 5-yard line.
Oh, that helps big time.
And unfortunately for the Dons, it's just part of the game.
Yep.
And he tried to get out of the way of it, and he calls it down at the 5-yard line, and so.
Yep, and it just happens. By any chance, did you see the clip where the field goal went off the official's head?
No.
You've got to look. It's online, but the field goal isn't going to make it. It hits the backfield judge in the head and bounces over for a field goal.
Boy, and the referee saw it coming, and he tried to get out of the way. And couldn't do it.
And,
so.
You know, McCackney, they practice that. McCackney actually did that on purpose, I think.
Yeah, right. That's just the way the coach drew it up.
Yep.
Good on the coach.
You scout the officials as well as the other team.
Be an Aggie in the Uintah Basin. No matter where you attend, your diploma will have the same three renowned words. Utah State University. Visit uintahbasin.usu.edu for details. Well, minute left here in the first half, and the Dons backed up 5 yards away, and the Utes trying to get pressure. There's a throw out to Stanton at the 8-yard line, and a great open
good
field
job.
Tackle by Cameron Peterson.
That's a good job right there.
Yeah, it just didn't bite on any of the fakes. Mm-hmm. Went for the hips and took him down.
And it's also a great pass and catch, so
56 seconds left. A little timeout on the field. We'll keep it here. Want to thank Savage Trucking. The Savage family founded the company in 1946 with a single truck hauling coal and timber in Utah. Today, they are a leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries, including electric power generation, coal production, oil refining, railroad, chemical, oil field downhole services, and other industries. Well, they're giving the freebies out at the crowd. That always gets everyone excited, except the girl that ducks her head and doesn't want any of it.
But usually somebody will hand one to her.
So, tonight's game also brought to us by B&D RV Center. B&D RV is proud to sponsor VTV's coverage of local high school football. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, B&D will assist you in your purchases. Stop in at 1570 West Highway 40 in Vernal to check out our on-the-lot inventory. Stanton, handoff, finds a hole at the 20 and taken down at the 25-yard line. Brandon Giles, I believe.
Yep, great job. Or that bus for even more than that.
And quickly to the line. The clock stops until the chains are set, so the Dons will be over the football and ready to go. And there's the mark. There's the signal. There is 55 seconds left here. Clock is running. There's going to be a false start penalty, I think. Didn't get everyone set. So the penalty will kill the clock and then back them up 5 yards. So be first and 15 from about the 23-yard line. Well, 27-9.
You see, and unfortunately on that is the clock actually starts here, and I'm not sure if Spanish Fork knows that. But the clock has started after the penalty.
Coming out of the huddle, they're going to take a lot of time off this clock. Started at 50 seconds, 15 seconds off. Ooh, there's a deep pass. And, boy, Sterling Tomato, and they're going to call a pass interference. That is just awful. I think that he came across the body of the receiver and knocked that ball down. Boy, I don't agree with that call at all.
Yeah, we'll have to look at that.
Watch Sterling Tomato here on the L&L Motor Replay. His eyes are on the ball. He is not looking at the defender. That ball's underthrown, and wow. He's looking at the ball the whole time and knocks it down. And here comes the dirty laundry.
You know, and it's one of those, even if it is interference, it's a great play because you're – only giving up 15 yards rather than 30. But, yeah, that's a pretty close call.
Believe it or not, that's the first penalty yardage for the Utes of the game.
You know, and this right here, the officials have to give the defense time to set after penalty. He should still be on the ball.
Thrown out to the sideline, caught and out of bounds by Higginson. Higginson's at the 47-yard line. 23 seconds left. Well, the referees are just like all the rest of us. And so after the out of bounds, the Dons can take a little bit more time to set this play up. Two receivers on each side. Chappelle on the backfield. Here comes a blitz from the Utes. It throws out to Stanton. Stanton has Peterson. Peterson runs him out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
And the one thing the Spanish Fork receivers are doing an excellent job is getting out of bounds. Catch the ball, get out of bounds. Get what you can, but get out of bounds.
So another first down. Clock stops. 19 seconds left at the 40-yard line. The Dons lead 27-9. Trying to tack on one more. And, you know, we talked about this in the break as well. The Utes right now, they're killing themselves with the turnovers. If they could hold on to the ball, this would be a whole different ball game.
Yes.
And they're not turnovers forced by the other team so much as they're just – you know, unfortunate plays. Chappelle, shotgun. Pressure comes from the right side. Lofts the ball up. Stanton nearly gets to it. Great coverage by Tomato. No flag this time.
Yeah, great inside position. Very seldom will you get interference on that. That's a great job. Again, great pass, great route. But the Ute defender right there.
Yeah, Sterling Tomano just had the inside position, and really he effectively became the receiver, and Stanton had to play defensive back in that case. Wow, I like the way that young man's head is turned towards the ball. He knows where the ball is. He's not playing the receiver.
Very sound fundamentally.
From the 40-yard line, second down, Chappelle looks right side. He's got Condi makes a couple of moves. And then he's taken down, and there's a flag.
I don't know what that's going to be for.
Boy, there was a stiff arm, but you can.
Yeah, and I don't think it's a hot horse collar because it looks like he's way low on the.
So we'll see what the call is. Here comes the conversation. But
4 seconds left, it looks like.
So they point against the Utes. Let's see if we can see on the L&L Motor replay. Here's
the thing
throw.
I think they're going to call is a horse collar.
No holding.
It's used because this is where.
It can't be a horse collar.
That's
You've
not
got
a horse collar.
And the flag was already on the ground before the horse collar, so.
But that, he's. Looks like it's going to go against Span. I don't know what it was there either.
Oh, I should have watched the referee instead of the replay, but. It's a 5-yard mark off. No, a 10-yard mark off. 15. Wow.
Man, I didn't see any players there.
They call a face mask.
So it must have been on the receiver, I guess.
Wow. I don't know that I understand that call. Okay, now we got a personal foul, and this is going to go against the Utes. So explain to me why this is an offsetting penalties replay of the down.
Because one's going to be dead ball, I bet.
It is high comedy on the field. I have no idea what just happened.
Yeah, I don't.
Apparently the face mask overrules the personal foul.
Well, they don't overrule because they marked them both off. Usually what it is, if one is a dead ball, you mark them both off. Because technically, a face mask is a personal foul as well.
The face mask has to be the stiff arm. I thought you could stiff arm.
But you can't grab the face mask. And so I didn't look. We can see if it's on the replay, and I'm not sure if he got a face mask or not. But I didn't see. Maybe somebody said something. Or okay, here it comes. Let's see if we get. There's nothing there.
Okay, so, jeez. And is that a personal foul?
See, I don't know.
Because he throws him down? This is football.
Because, yeah, that.
I mean, he wasn't malicious about it. He made sure the runner was on the ground.
I didn't see either of them, but.
So on to kick. After all that, 5 seconds left, and the Dons have their kicker on the field. And so far, special teams has not been the Spanish Fork Dons' friend. And so the kicker on the field from the 25-yard line.
Oh, that ball's
blocked. And it is a live ball and then tackled at the 22-yard line. And I think that it was blocked by Cameron Peterson. And we'll see here on the L&L Motor replay. Peterson just gets through the line. And, wow, two-hand spikes it down. And the kicker was James Daw. And there's a live ball, and he goes forward. And the Utes were celebrating. Fortunately, enough people had their eye on it.
Yeah.
That's going to end the first half. We're going to have a short break. We'll be back for highlights from L&L Motor replay and also the halftime entertainment. Stick with us.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashland Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uintah Basin.
It's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high-quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Come and see the professionals at Robinson Dental in Roosevelt. We specialize in cleaning, dental implants, whitening. Call us today and schedule your appointment. 435-725-3368.
Watching the Uets, we'll turn it over to them.
Halftime entertainment this evening, the Uets will be performing their routine, Only Love. The Uets are coached by head coach Elise Stewart and assistants Cody Murray, Kimberly Ross, and Melissa McCarty. The new coaching staff is loving working with this talented group of girls and can't wait for competition season. Now, here they are, your Uets.
Love can conquer all.
special thanks goes out tonight to our tailgating sponsors, Golden Corral, Colonel Cinemas, and Freddy's for their generous donations. We'd also like to thank the Territory Salon, the UHS Cheerleaders, Bright Orthodontics, and all those who have come and supported us today, all for providing great activities during the tailgating. Our tailgating...
Well, there you had the UETs, national champion UETs. New coach this year, though.
They look incredible again.
Yeah, and they just continue to do it year after year. We're here on VTV Channel 6. Got to watch both the cheerleaders and the drill team perform at halftime. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back with the L&L Motor Replays. Stick with us.
It's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Come and see the professionals at Robinson Dental in Roosevelt. We specialize in cleaning, dental implants, whitening. Call us today and schedule your appointment, 435-725-3368.
Do you surf the net every time you shop? Well, forget the hard drive and make the short drive down to L&L. We have the best selection in the basin. At L&L, we're making the car buying experience all that it can be, because we're not here just to sell you a car. We're here to build a long, happy relationship. L&L Motor, people you know, people who care.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uintah Basin.
It's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Come and see the professionals at Robinson Dental in Roosevelt. We specialize in cleaning, dental implants, whitening. Call us today and schedule your appointment, 435-725-3368.
Do you surf the net every time you shop? Well, forget the hard drive and make the short drive down to L&L. We have the best selection in the basin. At L&L, we're making the car buying experience all that it can be because we're not here just to sell you a car. We're here to build a long, happy relationship. L&L Motor, people you know, people who care.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are the locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Welcome back here on VTV Channel 6, and we want to go right into the highlights from the first half action brought to us by L&L Motor. And right off the bat, we have a big pass play. It's Carson Chapel hitting Jackson Higginson, who spins to his right and then just off to the races for the first touchdown. And then here we have a big, long pass. It's a strike from Chappelle to Sa'ali. And then Chappelle goes to the corner of the end zone, and this time he hits number 12, Wee Stanton. And here's a pass and throw caught by Dorian Walters for the Utes, and he's up and up across midfield and finally tackled out of bounds by the Dons. And they follow that up with an interception. Interception is by Nate Mattis, number 21, and then he's brought down by Walters well into Uintah territory. And then Mateen Lomax hits the 3-yard running score, and then this just great blocking, looking. Oaks finds Cruz Leyba, who gets across for the Utes lone touchdown of the first half. And Staten, deep pass. It just bobble. Staten catches it and runs in the end zone, and certainly helps pads Carson Chappelle's numbers with that catch. Big 40-yard touchdown strike there. So there we have the Ute fans. It's getting into the 40s. I don't think they care.
Nah, it's still great football weather.
And, you know, we want to look at this, you know, the stats from the first half. And the Utes just, you know, so they have some turnovers and they're killing themselves a little bit on offense, but they're not doing it in penalties.
No, they're moving the ball.
Yeah. Penalty yardage for the Utes, they only had 15 yards. No, it ended up being 30 with the additional penalty right at the end.
Right.
And nobody knows what happened. That was just a circus. So they had 30 yards of penalty. On the other hand, the Dons had 60 yards of penalties in the first half, and two of them were drive killers.
Right. And both, I mean, the big ones were obvious, too. We saw those. They weren't ones that you go, maybe. They were absolutely
right.
Correct calls.
The Utes had two turnovers, and ironically enough, the turnovers didn't hurt other than it would just kill potential scoring drives.
Right.
And the Dons unable to score on those. And the Dons had one turnover, and the Utes did take that back, and they scored off that one. So, anyhow, that's the kind of the tail of the tape of the first half, and we're a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter. We're going to take a short commercial break. We'll be right back here on VTV Channel 6.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Founded in 1946 by the Savage family,
family with a single truck. Today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uintah Basin.
It's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6. We're here at Coach Belcher Stadium, home of the Utes. And Coach Belcher Stadium, you know, we have to go back to 1995. Coach Belcher took the Utes to a state championship, played it on Rice-Eccles Stadium Field. And that was a pretty magical year.
It was incredible. I was lucky enough to be defensive coordinator that year. It was actually the first year VTV started covering Uintah Ute football.
Yeah, they've had, Dennis Mott probably on the call.
Dennis was there, and then they had a couple people, unfortunately, that no longer. Roy Espindola was one of the reporters, and unfortunately passed away a couple years ago. It was just great. And it's amazing the difference of broadcasting in that amount of time. I went into your facility, to VTV's facility, for the first time this week. Oh, my goodness.
If you haven't made it to VTV's new studio, you have to go take a visit. Dell Allred and Strata Networks have put together a state-of-the-art facility. One of the shows that they produce there is called The Sports Spin. Check it out Thursday at 6:30 every week. On VTV Channel 6, you'll see highlights from action here in the Uintah Basin, coaching and student interviews. And we're off in the third quarter. Another good return to the 32-yard line by the Utes. And field position has not been a problem for the Utes.
No, great job. And, you know, one thing, I don't even know if VTV realizes it, but I'm in Michigan at my nephew's wedding, and how nice it is for me to be able to click on and watch the game live. I mean, it's just unbelievable, and what a great service to the community.
And probably one of the things I look forward to the most, an uninterrupted football game with friends. And so the Utes, on their first possession of the second half, sticking with Oaks as the quarterback. Oaks has Walters, and he's got trouble, pushed up in the pocket, and he cannot escape the arm tackle, and he's going to be taken down by number 50, Kamei Harmon, who just cleaned up the garbage. And Oaks trying to stay strong
tough
in that pocket.
I mean, it's a coverage sack that he went there, didn't make a mistake. And this play right here, you'll see a lot about the confidence of Oaks. After you get sacked, will you come back?
There's a pitch, hits Walter. No, it's Jones, excuse me. Jones at
great
the 30.
Pitch.
Jones gets back to about the original line of scrimmage. And, man.
You know, play to calm, and I'll tell you, number 55 put a lick on Oaks right here.
He has done that all game. He is playing on the quarterback, and he's
you know, that's when you find out quarterback isn't fun all the time.
Yeah. Oaks looks to throw, pressure again.
But
and this time the ball squirts out, had Dallin Brakefield open just a hair behind him. And Oaks.
And a good pass. I mean, I'll tell you, this, again, you're talking about a sophomore coming in. First real action on varsity. Gets sacked, gets hit hard, and then makes a pretty good pass that would have been a first down.
Yeah, and one of the first ones to meet him on the sideline when he came in was Brody Franks, the senior. And, you know, hats off to a kid like Brody Franks, comes in his senior year, dealing with an injury, having to watch from the sidelines. But team player all the way.
Yep, that's why we have sports. Those lessons.
McCackney back to punt. Pressure comes from the left side and the middle. He gets off a doozy. It's going to be fair caught at the 39-yard line. Well, first possession's a three and out. And, you know, they started in a hole with the sack, put him back 7 yards, and couldn't get it back to move the chains forward. So now the Dons start at the 40-yard line, one of their better starting positions as far as field position goes. Shotgun again, handoff. Goes inside, breaks out left, gets past the first line of defense, and then brought down by Giles. Giles pretty excited.
Giles has a great angle to the ball right there.
Watch this inside out move and just gets that line to bite down. And Giles, wow, he is fast. He caught him from behind.
Oh, with the
shotgun blitz showing from the Utes. Here comes a blitz from the right side. Oh,
good
wow.
Job.
Yeah, and that is beautiful. And guess who it is? Brandon Giles just unblocked, and he just takes down Carson Chappelle, and a big-time loss right there. And kind of, ooh, you know.
I'll tell you, that's a great job by both Walters and Jones, controlling that side, not giving anything, and then – just finish it up from behind.
Blitz showing again. Coming from the right side. Oh, my goodness. Giles gets his just world rocked, but it turns into a tackle, and he's hopping. Wow. And I think that's going to be his knee kind of buckling from that hit. Knee or ankle. Oh, my goodness. Giles unblocked. And then he just gets clocked by the slot receiver.
Great job to hang on. And Brakefield comes in, finishes it out.
Yeah, and he's full of adrenaline. It's not until the play is over that he realizes he's hurt. My goodness. That's a big-time block, but Giles still somehow makes a tackle out of it. Chappelle looking to the left side, has a man. No, it just throws over everybody. Brakefield on coverage of the intended receiver was Colt Condi.
So a little different than the first half. Both defenses come out and do their job.
Wow. And Giles does his job.
All over the field.
Oh, my goodness. And hopefully he can get back right in the game because that was disruptive what he just did on the Don's first possession. Going that rugby style, going to the left. Does get it away, and it's a nice kick. Wow. Going to be downed at the 12-yard line. My goodness. That's a big kick.
That's a huge foot.
You know, they're kicking from the 40-yard line, and they down it. They mark it at the 14 is where the final marking is. My goodness. Wow. Forty-six-yard punt, and it pins the Utes well back, 14-yard line. Worst field position for the Utes the whole game. Oaks, shotgun. Oaks, it's a handoff up the middle. Jones just punishes anyone that wants to make shoulder contact with him.
Great spin, and just keep the legs going.
So a big run on first down makes it second and about four.
That's a great block by Murray. I mean, nice pull, comes out, and absolutely seals the hole to allow a great first down play.
From the 20-yard line, looking to throw, pressure, and he had to get rid of it in a hurry. And, yeah, the Dons had the ball and ran in the end zone, but it was a pass, and it was an incomplete pass right from the get-go. Why they let him run that long. You know, the back line judge just kind of backed off. And
yeah, you got to blow the whistle there.
Yeah, so.
I mean, because what they do is in college and pro now, you don't necessarily blow it just in case if you overturn it. High school, they're not overturning anything. If it's an incomplete, call it.
From shotgun. It's a run. Walters at the 20. Walters pushing. Walters very close to a first down, maybe a yard short.
And that time you have Jacoby Mold out leading the way. Again, great seal block block to get the runner going.
So the punt team comes on the field. Down 27-9, middle of the third quarter. I don't know. I guess it's hard to turn the ball over on the 21-yard line if you don't get the point after. So McCagney to punt. There's been pressure from the Dons on every kick. This one's well blocked, and he gets off a good punt. It's high-hanging punt, and he's going to be fielded at the well, I don't understand that.
Yeah, no, you don't get the ball there.
They mark it at the 42-yard line, but the receiver called for the fair catch at the 42-yard line, but then ran backwards and caught it at the 39. That's just an interesting mark. I don't know. It's just the wrong mark, not interesting. So you'll see here on the L&L motor replay, so he's calling for fair catch at the 42-yard line.
Should be on the 40.
So the Dons from shotgun, handoff, Lomax. Lomax turns. Lomax with about 9 yards. And with the forward momentum, looks like he might have the first down.
You know, just great leg strength and good explosion through the hole.
Close to first down. They're going to call it a first down. We just got the score, VTV6 covering the Union game. The Union's down right now, 14-28, and they are playing the number one team in their region right now.
That's a Morgan. So that's a good game by the Cougars.
And here comes two flags. I think it's going to be an illegal block downfield. And that's going to cost a number of yards. So here on the L&L motor replay, look at the angle of this one. They see Chappelle right into Condi. And here's Condi. And do we see where the flag is? Oh, there's the block in the back. It's pretty obvious. Yeah, and right in front of the referee in here, you can see the laundry coming out. Yep, there's back is the call. We had the pleasure of sitting over the Dons fans, and what do you think they think of that? Thought of that call, Kevin?
I think they thought it was a horrible call. Horrible.
So back it up to the 35-yard line.
Still enough to move the chainsaw.
Yeah, first down after a big catch and run by Colt Condi, and that senior is shifty. Boy, he can dance left and right so quick. There's another look off, low pass, going to be a catch by Higginson for about 5 yards.
I'll tell you, he has had a great game.
Yeah. Well, you know, Higginson opened up the scoring. 78-yard pass from Carson Chappelle, and it's been just one big play after another for that young man. Chappelle looks like a misdirection handoff. Can't get to him was Jones, but then who does get there is Dallin Brakefield, and also in on the tackle was number 27, Trevor Slaw, the senior.
That's a great job by Slaw. Good pursuit by the Utes.
Mateen Lomax, the ball carrier, brings up third and short for the Dons, and they've shown they'll go for it on fourth down. So they're going to bring in kind of their option quarterback here. It's number 8. We've seen a few plays for Noah Conway. So he lines up not as an option quarterback, but as a deep running back. And they hand it off the short back. And did he get it? It looks like he's short.
So it's going to bring up fourth.
Fourth down. A lot of misdirection. Jones slow to get up off the turf, and he does. So fourth and one from the 32-yard line. And maybe a little more still on the field's number 8 is Noah Conway. And look for that same action. You got the Conway going out to the right side, and they didn't go that direction this time, but it's going to be similar play, and it's going to be a quarterback keeper Well done by Chappelle, and he picks up the first down to the 19-yard line.
Yeah, well-designed play. Change it up a little bit and got the first. Looks like we do have a player down.
Yeah, one of the Spanish Fork Dons players is down. We're going to take a short timeout here at VTV6. We'll be right back.
Do you surf the net every time you shop? Well, forget the hard drive and make the short drive down to L&L. We have the best selection in the basin. At L&L, we're making the car buying experience all that it can be because we're not here just to sell you a car. We're here to build a long, happy relationship. L&L Motor, people you know, people who care.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6, the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons. First and 10 at the Ute 20-yard line. And they've got the same package in. And this time Chappelle looking for the left corner of the end zone. Has a man open, and it's just too easy. And they're looking for pass interference, but no, it's not going to be. And I believe the pass was to Jackson Higginson.
And yeah, it's one of those, I think, if he doesn't catch it, they're going to throw the flag there. But since he caught it.
So and the Utes want the pass interference with the push-off, and in on the defense was Cameron Peterson. But, wow.
Great
touch.
I'm going to
say, Chappelle has put the ball in the breadbasket on so many of these passes tonight. And finally, the kicking game for the Mighty Dons, maybe their lone weak spot, works. So now 34-9, Utes down. Want to thank Robinson Dental. Robinson Dental is proud to sponsor VTV's coverage of high school football. Call us today at Robinson Dental for your appointment. We look forward to seeing your smile. You can see Coach Allen talking to Peterson. He says, what you do there is get big. Block that ball with your hands. Coach him up right there.
The other thing you say, you know what? Interfere. It's okay to interfere there because it's not a touchdown. But, you know, that's just great touch by the quarterback and great hands and concentration by the receiver. Another big game that's important to both of these teams, Maple Mountain is beating Wasatch. It's kind of a three-team tournament for the four spot right now between Wasatch, Uintah, and Spanish Fork. And all the teams kind of have it all in their own hands. You win, you go on.
So the Utes need a little help if they lose tonight.
Yeah, what would have to happen if Wasatch loses, which it looks like they're going to, and then Uintah would need Wasatch to beat Spanish, and then Uintah would have to beat Wasatch, and then that would be a three-way tie, and you'd do one of those half games. Spanish Fork, if they beat Wasatch, if they beat Uintah and then beat Wasatch, they're in.
A little bit getting loosey-goosey out there, number 53, Tino Leilua. And enjoying himself out on the field. Boy, look at these camera angles. That's great. You right up and close and personal. Motion man's Leyba. Pitch to Leyba. Leyba turns it up. And then Leyba met by a number of Dons, including number 50, Kamea Harmon.
Great angle, stayed home, made the hit.
We saw Leyba earlier in the half. He scored the touchdown, the lone touchdown for the Utes. But the Dons have certainly marked him, made it hard for him to get off. And, boy, Oaks in trouble. Oaks taken down And it's number 52, Jared Van Schindel, on the tackle.
And that play just didn't develop. The Dons just blew it up.
And that's what you want on that option, is you want that end to bite down. But in that case, the end bit down, and he was at the point of the handoff.
You don't want him to bite down quite that soon.
Yeah. So, Oaks made the right call. It just, great defensive play, and Oaks in trouble. And again, and it's Van Schindel holding on to Oaks' legs, and then a nice show of sportsmanship from Campbell.
And Oaks does a good job to put it in the vicinity of Jones to not get a grounding, but to keep it from being a sack.
Here comes the kicking team. Want to remind you, later in the game, we get to choose a player of the game. The Maze at Water Hall Ranch will give two tickets to player of the game. We'll pick that from the UNA side. McCackney calls for the ball. McCackney hits it off the side of his foot, kind of a wobbly kick, dies at the 39-yard line. Boy. Yeah, that just
I mean, artificial turf, sometimes it just does that.
You know, you see the ball bounce forward, backwards, sidewards, but how many times do you see it hit and die at the same spot? It was like it was a dead spot in the field. You see that on basketball all the time.
Or golf.
Yeah, it's got some backspin on it.
Yep.
We used to call games before Altamont remodeled their buildings. And their basketball court was famous for that. You'd be bouncing along, and that ball would just stop. It wouldn't come back up. Oh, boy, big pass. Caught. Oh, no, hit the turf, and it's incomplete. I thought Higginson was going to make another spectacular grab.
I'll tell you what he does is he adjusts to the ball so well when it's in the air.
Yeah, and it's just a – this is a pass play that Chappelle just didn't have enough time. So it's good pressure for the Utes. They hit him as he threw, and that's what caused that incompletion. So it's good penetration.
Good job by the DL.
Here comes a blitz from the Utes. There's a quick slant. Oh, it's picked off. It's going to be Dustin Brakefield, and he's at the 40. He's at the 50. He's got blockers out front. He's at the 40, and he's taken down at the 30-yard line of the Spanish Fork Dons.
I'll tell you, that's something the brothers are going to talk about. Great hit by Brakefield, which causes an interception for Brakefield.
Yeah, so here's the pass from Chappelle, and you're right. Dallin Brakefield goes up high and just tackles James Daw, and then Dustin Brakefield picks up the ball in the air, and he returns it all the way down to the Spanish Fork 29-yard line. And the Utes in great shape here on this possession.
Good spark by the defense.
There's a handoff. Good upfield block. Oh, my goodness. He makes that cut, and you see him slam the turf, Kevin. That's an upset kid because he knew he was getting a touchdown.
So somebody got a hand on a foot, it looks like.
Wow. Leyba came through there and had a – upfield blocking, and that cut to the right was going to spring him. You'll watch this play. Let's see who gets a hand on him because Leyba comes through there, and, boy, I didn't see it.
Yeah, I think it was the turf monster.
Maybe just the turf monster when he tried to make that cut to the right. So here's a running play to Jones. Jones dives ahead to about the 16-yard line.
Good job to get positive yardage.
So 34-9, about a minute 48 left here in the third period. Utes in scoring position right here at the 16-yard line, second and 9. Goes to Jones. Pushes forward to about the 16-yard line. Still pushing. No, it was Leyba was the ball carrier. Harmon in on the tackle. So third and maybe 8. Two up the middle runs in a row. So Leyba and Jones in the backfield with Oaks. And here's a flag. Encroachment.
That's going to be a...
How can they have encroachment? Wow, that's interesting. Have you seen it called that early?
Yeah, in high school, as soon as you cross the plane, it's off that you don't get a chance to get back. But usually, especially that quick, there's a little bit of leeway.
Yeah.
But the rule is if a defensive player's offsides, they're offsides.
That's
and
just
so we probably just lined up offsides.
Third and four after the penalty.
Changes the third down.
Oaks. Oaks spins to his right, throws, has Leyba. Leyba! Leyba blocking!
Score.
Oh, man.
Oh, Brakefield. Nice job.
Yeah, and it's Dustin Brakefield, and he's got the you know, the block on number 28 for the Dons, and that's what springs it for sure. Watch the spin here. Oh,
I
man.
I mean, watch the play action.
Wow. And here's the catch, and it's not only Brakefield, but did you see Corbin Allen come back
for
the kick-out block?
Yeah, Corbin just makes a pop.
Wow. And that is Leyba's second touchdown of the game. And I don't want to call it too early, but, you know, the young man has 12 of the 15 points so far. We might be finding out who our corn maze player of the game is. So for the two-point conversion, Oaks has Jones in the backfield. Pitches. Leyba on the option. Leyba looking to the end zone. Pumps. Leyba still on his feet and then tackled. And really well defended by the Dons.
It was.
So Leyba on the 13-yard TD. And the Utes score their second touchdown, third scoring drive of the game.
And those are big points because that actually does give you a chance to win a ball game.
37 seconds left here in the half, and there you see the flags going around. And on a cold night here, now it's starting to turn a little bit cold, but the Ute high school fans.
Yeah, you just stand a little closer to the person next to you.
Yeah. And then you dance like a wild person. That usually fixes all your coldness.
Oh, and there are some moves going on up there.
Wow. I haven't moved like that in 25 years. Yep. Near in the 30s, 41 degrees outside right now. McCackney in the kick. The cold air makes those balls a lot harder when you kick. It's an onside kick,
and
the Utes
are going to
recover it. Oh, and the Utes do recover it. A little trickery by the Utes, and it's Dallin Brakefield on the recovery. And maybe I spoke too soon about player of the game. Dallin Brakefield on the recovery, and what an execution. Look at the kick by McCackney. And he could have just picked it up himself.
Yeah.
And you know what? That's a wise play by McCackney because he realized he was 8 yards.
Right.
And so instead of picking up the ball, he went and blocked. Oh, my goodness.
You know, the thing I look for is possibly that hitting a Ute before the 10 yards, but it didn't.
That's it. So. That's a well-executed onside kick and a gutsy call by the Uintah coaching staff. And McCackney sets the Utes up. Jones trying to cut back. Jones met by a host of Dons, including number 50, Kamea Harmon. And Jones took a couple of licks earlier in the third period, and it almost looks like he's a half step slow.
Yeah, my guess is they're going to let this go down.
You can see Jones just a little hobble in his step, but 14 seconds left of the Utes try to get one more play before the quarter ends, and it does look like that's what they're going to do. Oaks in shotgun. Oaks looking to the left. Oaks has a man.
Oh, great pass, great catch.
And that is Dallin Brakefield. Breaks across the 50-yard line, and that'll end the third quarter with the Utes in great position at the 39-yard line. We'll be right back. Okay, there you go.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They are also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
We're back here on VTV Channel 6, and the Utes threatening to make a ball game out of this, Kevin.
Yeah, you score here, and it's a ball game.
You get it within two scores, and just about anything can happen in a fourth period. You know, we've seen, and it's happened to the Dons, where they were leading, can't remember if it was Maple Mountain or, but they were ahead in the fourth quarter. Had a running out the clock situation, had a fumble, and ended up losing a game by 2 points. So anything can happen. Oaks in shotgun has Jones in the backfield with him. Low snap. Oaks has it. Oaks throws.
Great
has a
pass.
Receiver. It's Leyba. Leyba at the 28-yard line where he's out of bounds. They mark him down at the 27-yard line. And Leyba has come to life.
Yeah, good players find a way to become visible. He's kind of hidden for the first, but good players will eventually be seen.
And he was crafty on that Hunter Clark on the coverage in kind of a zone. He's sitting into that hole, and Leyba hid behind him and then broke outside, created his own openness. Oaks throws, hits as he's thrown, and drives the ball into the dirt. The young man bounces off the turf like we expect those kids made out of rubber to do. So second and 10 after the incompletion.
You know, I've been very impressed with Oaks. He's just run the team really well.
Leyba in motion, handoff to Jones. Jones breaks up to about the 25-yard line. Brings up third and long. About third and 8 after the run. And, you know, the Dons continue to play that man defense. They're one guy is responsible for the quarterback. One guy is responsible for this running back.
And they're playing physical.
They're hitting the quarterback on every play. Oaks, shotgun, steps back to pass, has a guy open. Oh, and he just threw behind Corbin Allen. Corbin broke out of his route and was open, and the ball was 2 yards behind him. So maybe Oaks is expecting him to kind of sit on his route, and he breaks out to the right.
It looks like the Utes are going to go for it.
Sure.
I was trying to figure out if a field goal helps, and it kind of does, but not enough. I mean, to make it, you'd need 2 8-point.
Fourth and about 7. Oaks looking downfield. Oaks has a guy open. Corbin Allen with a nice catch.
Great play. Good. Oh, and Oaks just hangs in tough. He knows he's going to be hit. My guess is it's going to be a roughing. We'll look on there. I don't think it's a hold. Yeah, I think that's going to be a roughing. Yep.
And Corbin Allen, wow. He's got some really sure hands, and at 6'5", he's such a big target.
Yeah, and just so consistent. Runs good patterns, does everything technically right.
So roughing is going to be a boy, and Jones is really hobbled out there. You see him just kind of. So Leyva's going to go get the instructions from the coach 2 or 3 times now. No, he's out. Okay, so Leyva's out. You have Jones and Walters. And then there's going to be a timeout. And so the Dons kind of probably understand the importance of this.
Yeah, because what they don't want to do is let Uintah back in this ball game.
And, yeah. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so timeout on the field. We'll be right back after these messages.
come and see the professionals at Robinson Dental in Roosevelt. We specialize in cleaning, dental implants, whitening. Call us today and schedule your appointment, 435-725-3368.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Founded in 1946 by the Savage family with a single truck, today, Savage is the leader in supply chain management solutions that are tailored to meet the needs of our customers across a variety of industries. We are a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage and the community here in the Uintah Basin.
Oaks up under center, hands off to Jones, and Jones gets very close to a touchdown. They call him down about the one-yard line. And that's a new look for the Utes. You don't see a lot of under center plays.
Yep. And,
and there's the handoff to Jones, has a lead block.
Led by Jacoby Mold again. Great job leading the way.
So brings up second and short, and looks like the Utes jumped. Little bit of
fun.
A little bit of fun on the field after that play. And so what's the call? I think it's a false start, right? No, that's an encroachment. So they're going to back him up half the distance again. That puts the ball inside the one-yard line. So the Utes just inching closer with 10:30 left in the fourth quarter. Under center again, Oaks. Oaks hands off to Jones. Jones gets the touchdown with the 1 yard.
Just keeps those legs pounding.
And so the Utes breathe new life into the football game. And look at this. It's just my line against your line. And Jones keeps the legs moving until he finds the gap and dives in. So, two-point conversion? No, it's going to be the extra point. Right now, the spread is a 13-point game. We talked about those critical extra points earlier. So, both teams missing, but so many for the Dons. McCackney is good.
Just right down the middle.
And so it's a 12-point game. You can win the game. You have to score two touchdowns to do it.
And it's doable.
It is doable.
You know, again, we talked about Utes do not give up, and they found a way to crawl back in there, scratch a little bit.
Yeah, showing heart here and toughness, getting critical yards when they needed them, not afraid to go up the middle, and go against a stout defensive line for the Dons. And so the Dons coach is upset, is maybe the kindest way to say this right now. He's been out talking to referees since that play ended. Enjoy reliable wireless coverage and unbeatable speeds from Strata Networks, the company that brings you more local cell sites than any other carrier. Nationwide 4G LTE coverage and the latest devices from your favorite brands. Strata Networks is a proud sponsor of ETV's live coverage of high school football. Stop into a Strata store today and ask about their new unlimited talk and text plan for only $20 a month. Now you can have the plan you love at a price you love too.
I'll tell you, they have everybody up. I wouldn't mind seeing a ball drop right around the 35.
Well, that 40-yard line is wide open.
Yep. And especially on, if you kick it this side, you've got a good shot.
So if they can kick to the left side, McCackney's a right-footed kicker, the way he lines up. And here comes the kick, and it's going to be a line drive. That seems to be one that he might have been trying to hit a player with a pop and missed. And so the Dons will set up at about the 36-yard line on the return from Stanton. So that looked to me like one where he's trying to hit a line drive into a player.
I'll tell you, Dallin Brakefield makes a nice pop on that one.
So the Dons at the 36-yard line. The clock right now needs to run. Would not be surprised to see a lot of runs from the Dons. But they have the wonderful arm of Chappelle. There's the handoff. Gets through the first line of the defense. Tackled inbounds. Brings up second and about four. That looks like 3 yards. And so, clock running. Chappelle and shotgun. Chappelle with Lomax in the backfield has blitz showing from the Utes. Picked up by the Dons. First down and then out of bounds. And that's good for the Utes, but bad for the first down. Higginson with the reception.
So right now, again, great job by the Dons to be able to pass. You know that, you know, they know it's a ball game and they're not going to go ultra conservative.
9:37 left here in the game. The Dons at their own 47-yard line. Chappelle has three to the left side. There's the handoff. And boy, good pursuit from the Utes, but still.
Oh, and a ball almost came out.
Yeah. You see Lomax bobbling as he's being tackled, and that's the kind of break the Utes need. So here's dancing around, good pursuit from the Utes, and Lomax trying to find an opening. Oh, wow, what you see that strip.
Yep.
Who was that on the strip? That was number 74, was that who it was? Couldn't tell. Blitz showing from the Utes coming in.
Oops, that's going to cost him five.
Little bit of a rock back. And well, he's the one that induced me.
Yeah, but well, but he's 7 yards back. He can do that.
Yeah.
A lineman can't do that because he goes off sides, but a defensive back can do that.
Brings up second and nine after the penalty. That was kind of comical.
It was.
Well, interesting. Second and nine. The Dons on the 48-yard line, 8:21. Clock is ticking. Looking to throw, has a man open.
Oh, he's down. So big play right here. I mean, this is a huge play.
Third and five. I guess it'll be six from the mark of the spot. Condi was the receiver, and his knee was down when he caught. Brakefield still laid a lick on him. So coming in from the sideline was Chappelle, went to go get some instruction from the coach. And, Kevin, this really critical to the game.
This is.
They get this one.
You get it with 7.5 minutes left.
Utes, pressure at the line. Three to the left, one to the right. Chappelle looking to the right. Chappelle looks to run. Chappelle runs out of room, and he's down at the 45-yard line, and he's short. Brings up fourth and two, and fourth and one with the spot.
And remember, the punter has been incredible tonight.
Indeed he has. The punter, the kicker is James Daw, and they run up basically just kind of a rolling out left.
And, well, I mean, it's a good play. The clock's running. He almost made it. And he is going to take off, and he is.
And he kicks kicks it after that. And, boy, you know, oh, my goodness. I don't know how he got that app. He was wrapped
either.
Up. And, you know, it wasn't Dye. It was number 12, Stanton.
It
was the kicker. And you see there on the look at the replay, look at the referee. He's like, wow.
I've never seen that before.
So here on the L&L Motor replay, so Stanton comes up. He looks like he's going to run, and he's wrapped up right here and just uses a little stiff arm to spring himself. And you would have surprised you if it was Brandon Giles that nearly had the tackle for the loss and the turnover. Wow. And instead it's a beauty of a kick. Pins the Utes on the 15-yard line.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
Well, it's kind of an option fake.
Option fake reverse.
Yeah, if you've got it, run it.
Yeah, put the new twist in. Reverse back and
So the Utes, 15-yard line. Oaks keeps it himself. Oh. Nicely done. Oaks trying to get free. Oh, and the ball comes out. They call it down. Yeah. They call it down.
Well, the
no,
one.
No, no, no. They do give it a turnover.
Yep. So. The beanie came out. The beanbag came out.
So the Utes turn it over on their first play after the punt. And here it is. Ooh, it just was a turnover. Oaks was on top of him when he lost control of the ball.
That's a good job stripping the ball. Oaks actually is covering up the ball pretty well.
Yeah.
Just a good defensive play to come in and strip it.
And Ermston with the recovery. Well done by the Dons, who are back in business. First and goal, or first and 10 at the 20-yard line. And, boy, what a big run from Mateen Lomax. Drives it all the way up to the 6-yard line, 7-yard line is where the spot is. And Lomax, just some big blocks. And brought down by Breakfield and also Sterling Tomato. Bend but don't break, Utes. Dig in here. 7 yards of turf between you and the game. There's a handoff to Lomax again. Lomax up to the 3-yard line.
And, they're going to call a late hit right there. And that usually is going to get somebody chewed out.
So be a half the distance the goal penalty.
No, I think it's going to come this way.
Oh, go against the
from what I saw, it's going to come this way.
So here's the conversation. Ashley Regional is a strong supporter of local sports teams. Ashley Regional is now a level 4 trauma center and has recently been designated as chest pain accredited. Want to thank Ashley Regional and all of our sponsors for helping us bring you tonight's game. Still conversation.
You know, this shouldn't be talked. If an official saw it, you call it.
Yeah. There's
this isn't an out of bounds, and will you see it?
Here's the ball carriers down. And is that the late hit?
Yep.
And is the retaliation they're going to call?
Nope. That's what they called because there's where the flag came.
So, they offset the penalties. So the initial push comes from, I think it was number 52, Tukafu. And then Giles with the retaliation and offsetting penalties.
And
which is probably my least favorite call in all of football.
Call it or don't.
You know, somebody was wrong. You know, somebody created the problem.
When you look at the replay, was there a problem?
You know, I don't think so. I think that was two kids that were just playing through the whistle. And
yep.
No harm, no foul, and I guess that's what they call, essentially.
And then again, you also want to keep control of a ball game. I understand that as well.
Chappelle under center pitches out. He's got the runner is Conway. Conway cuts it back in. Conway scores. And the Dons just spread the field out. And Conway scores, and Conway really took some abuse.
I'll tell you, you watch Allen on this. This is a great job forcing the play inside. He does his job. He forces it in, and unfortunately, there's just not the inside person. Great job by the defensive end right there.
So the Dons, after the turnover, so third turnover of the game for the Utes, and the Dons use that one to seal the game. Now lead 40-22, and into looks like a what is this, like the old duck play from the there's a little flinch and they're gonna call a false start.
Yeah.
So Stanton was the quarterback in this case. Conway, number 8, Noah Conway. And usually you see them line up, and then they just shift the line over. Nobody actually snaps it from that position. But they did, but false start negates it. So they're going to go right back to that action. Conway And if I was the Utes, I'd just bring five guys right after him, you know. And he throws the end zone in the corner and throws it out of bounds. So all the trickery for nothing. And why would you run an option play like that? And it's not that Noah Conway's not a great player, but if you're going to throw a fade to the corner, you got the best quarterback I've seen all season.
Run it from
– right.
Just run a play.
Right. Let Chappelle throw that ball. I mean, Chappelle has been putting just dimes out there. He's dropping balls into guys' hands. They don't even have to catch it. They just have to put their hands out. So the Dons lead 40-22. They're going to kick off. And the Utes, with 6 minutes left in the game, need to make something happen quick. The Savage family founded the company in 1946 with a single truck hauling coal and timber in Utah. Today, they are a leader in supply chain management solutions and are proud to help VTV Channel 6 bring you tonight's game. So into kick is Spencer Red. Red hits a squibbly bouncy kick, picked up by Peterson. Peterson dives forward to the 30-yard line. And that's where the Utes will have it. 6:01 left here in the ball game.
So it looks like Maple Mountain has opened up a 31-6 lead over Wasatch. Let me see if I get the Union score. And Morgan's opened it up a little bit on Union, 37-14.
They're there in the third quarter right now, so. Oaks looking deep. Oaks throws it over everybody's head. Tended receiver was Dustin Brakefield. And that's where just another half step backwards, another half count, because Brakefield is – he's going to get open, but the ball was thrown just a hair too soon. I didn't see if there was pressure, which forced Oaks to throw that earlier. Jones spinning. Jones stacked up at the 30-yard line.
So it looks like Jones might be coming out of the game.
Yeah, he is significantly hobbling. He's going to make it to the sideline. And he's been a little gimpy since about midway through the third quarter, which, you know, that's such a huge weapon for the Utes that it's tough to adjust to the loss. In this case, Kiever, the sophomore, is in his place. Going deep. Oh, picked off by number 12, Stanton.
And again, that's not bad. That's a decent punt right there. Throw it up there. If you get it, you get it. If you don't, it's a punt.
On third down, Oaks hit right when he throws. Stanton turns and then tackled immediately by Leyva. So at the 35-yard line, that's the fourth turnover of the game for the Utes.
I think we'll look at Spanish keeping it on the ground right here.
Yeah, 5:16 left. It's the time to ground and pound. Chappelle, shotgun, hands off. Lomax coming back across the action. Lomax still on his feet. Lomax crossed the 50-yard line down at the 45. They mark him down at the 44-yard line.
We've got three people slow getting up.
Yeah, and that could be a bad injury for the Dons. It's number 12 that's down. Oh, gosh, you know what that? He was coming back and just had a guy run up into his shins. So we're going to take a break with the injury here. We'll be right back here on VTV Channel 6.
Given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Do you surf the net every time you shop? Well, forget the hard drive and make the short drive down to L&L. We have the best selection in the basin. At L&L, we're making the car buying experience all that it can be, because we're not here just to sell you a car. We're here to build a long, happy relationship. L&L Motor, people you know, people who care.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6. The injured Don was Way Stanton. He was coming back, you know, kind of trying to throw a block, and the two players rolled up into his knee, and he's putting a little pressure on that, and hopefully that young man's okay. Such a critical piece to the Don's offensive attack. And so here, first and 10 after the run from shotgun, Chappelle. Hands off again, ball carriers Lomax. Lomax gets through, Lomax tackled by Dustin Brakefield. And Lomax a little upset, and all of his buddies turned him back to the huddle. Not sure what he's upset about here, Kevin.
Great run, keeps his.
Just a high shoulder tackle.
Yeah, there's.
Nothing wrong with that.
Do you surf
whatsoever.
The net every time?
Almost like he's pointing like it's a horse collar, but no, that's just good high tackle. It's the Dons from the Ute 28-yard line. Looking to add a little insult to injury here. 4:05 left in the game. From shotgun. Handoff. Lomax. Lomax dances, and you know, it's pretty easy when you're 5 yards deep before you get touched. That offensive line is opening up some holes. I mean, wow. Aggies are everywhere with two convenient locations in Vernal and Roosevelt. USU, Uintah Basin makes a college degree possible with your schedule in your hometown. Visit uintahbasin.usu.edu for details. Well, content to let that run. Play clock's down to 6. And Chappelle's probably under directions to snap it at 2, and that's what he does. Hand off to Lomax again. Bleeds for another first down. Gets to the 17-yard line.
And so what the Utes, I believe they play next week. The Utes need Wasatch to beat Spanish Fork to keep their playoff play-in hopes alive.
The Utes non-conference game next week, is that correct, Ogden?
Yes, I believe it's Thursday too.
So short week, play on Thursday. Pitch out, looking for room, gets the edge, has some room, and gets to the touchdown, and it's a nice run. The ball carrier is Noah Conway, and that's been his thing, get him out in the open space.
We do have a flag down, though.
Oh, flag at the 19-yard line. It's holding. That one will come back. And so more penalty yards, threatening to go over the 100 penalty yards for the game are the Dons.
Yeah, I'm not.
And penalties have taken away 2 scoring drives already.
Yes.
So. Moon Lake Electric has been in business since 1938, owned by the people they serve. Moon Lake is a cooperative, not privately owned. So kind of a power set, and Chappelle just realizes the play's broken and tucks it and goes up.
And again, Chappelle very aware, makes sure that he stays in.
And then the penalty flag is just going to be on sportsmanlike conduct on the Utes. That's too bad. Just thrown in after the play. And Chappelle came up gimpy. Boy, if I'm the Dons, I'd say my backup quarterback's in. Yep. My backup receiver's in. I mean, shoot, we've already seen an injury to Stanton. At this point, there's no use in hurting your starters.
That's going to go against Spanish as well.
Oh, wow. So they threw it in the backfield of the Utes. Did you see how they threw it after the play?
Yeah, I have no idea.
So I thought for sure that was against the Utes, but it goes against the Dons, and that's a 15-yarder. So, no, Chappelle's back in the game. Chappelle's in, gimping and all.
See if they go into victory formation right here.
207
I agree
left.
With you. I just wouldn't risk. You have a big game next week.
Well, you see him just gimping into the thing, you know.
You know what I mean? He has had a great game.
Yeah, I mean, even if you have a missed snap here, you're – so no victory formation. 150 left. Up by 18. It's a handoff. And diving forward is Lomax. Brings up second and long, nearly 20. .127 clock running. Chappelle. Shotgun has receivers, two to the right, two to the left. Lomax is in the backfield. Waiting for the clock to run down. It's at 7 on the play clock. Snaps it at 2 seconds. It's a handoff. And I said it was Lomax, but it was not. I think it was Peterman. Oh, no, Betancourt, number 26, Caesar Betancourt. He's a senior.
Comes in and makes the hit.
49 seconds left. And I think this is your victory formation, bringing the starters back in for that.
Yeah, it looks like one play, and this should do it.
So that's it here at Uintah High School. The Utes hosting the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons, and in victory formation, they take a knee, and the Dons keep their playoff hopes alive. And make it tough for the Utes to get there. The Utes need help at this point. And they trail, they lose this game 40-22. Now we're going to take a short break. We'll be right back for the L&L Motor replay highlights. And also the selection of the player to the game. We'll be right back.
Come and see the professionals at Robinson Dental in Roosevelt. We specialize in cleaning, dental implants, whitening. Call us today and schedule your appointment. 435-725-3368.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6. The Utes hosting the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons, and the Dons come away with a victory 40-22. We're going to do some highlights and want to remind everyone to run over to Facebook here in about 10 minutes. We're going to have a Facebook Live. Kevin and I will go down the booth and hopefully grab one of the Uintah coaches. But here on the L&L Motor Replay Highlights, it's a quick pitch out to Higginson, who spins and then uses his speed to go 78 yards to the house. And that's how it opened for the Utes, or for the Dons. And then Chappelle going deep, finding number 24, Sa'ali, for a deep pass. Then Chappelle going to the corner of the end zone this time, finding a way, Stanton. And then the Utes looking, throwing, big pass completion to Dorian Walters, rumbling up the field into the Dons territory. And then Henderson throws, and the linebacker just jumps the route and returns it back into Utes territory. The return by Nate Mattis, tackled by Walters. Then a handoff, short run for Mateen Lomax, the workhorse for the Dons. Then change of quarterback, Oaks looking around, throwing, finding Cruz Leyba, who gets into the end zone for the first of his two scores on the night. And then here's a play that just, the bounce went the Dons' way. You know, perfect position by the Utes, and Stanton, the lucky recipient. Brandon Giles having a night with a big sack. Chappelle, corner of the end zone again. He's got great touch, found Higginson there for his second score. And then right there, the Brakefield brothers breaking it up. Dustin Brakefield with the big return, setting up a Utes scoring play there. Right here, rolling out, finding Leyba, Corbin Allen, and Brakefield with the big blocks. And Leyba goes in untouched. And then the driving touchdown by Mike Jones for 1 yard. And this was the one that kind of sealed the game. The run by Noah Conway. And then turnovers by the Utes. See the Utes out there taking a knee on their end zone. Kevin, any last thoughts before we go away?
You know, I was proud of the Utes. Didn't give up. Came back. Made a ball game in it. I was really pleased with the play of Oaks coming in. That's a tough situation for a young sophomore to come in a difficult game against a good ball team, and came in and played well.
And as a sophomore, building something there. We have two tickets to give away to the Maze at Water Hollow Ranch in Bluebell. Player of the game, Kevin, who's your vote for? I'll let you pick.
Okay, I'll go with Leyba offensively. Mm-hmm. And who would you go with, D?
I'd have to go Brandon Giles.
So. I think so, too. I mean, he brought a lot of – not only did he play well, he brought a lot of energy to the defense.
Yeah, and so we've got to pick one of those two. Who would you say? I'm gonna go defensively.
I think so, too.
I think, Giles played a lot of energy and heart, and let's give it to somebody that's, you know, in the trenches kind of doing dirty work.
And so. If Cruz complained, Cruz, just come find me. I'll pay for yours.
Yeah, we'll find you some tickets.
I got you covered, Cruz.
So there it is. Meet us over in Facebook in just a few minutes for the Facebook Live post-game interview. Hopefully we'll have one of the coaches there. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.